Subscribe Technical Babaji channel and press the bell icon to get the latest video updates.
Hello friends, it's me Tariq Akhtar Ansari. In this video, I'm going to explain bubble sort algorithm. I have already written the definition of bubble sort. Bubble sort is the simplest sorting algorithm that works by repeatedly swapping the adjacent elements if they are in wrong order. So I will explain the bubble sort with practical example. Here you can see I have written the one syntax of the programming languages, and here I will use the C++ programming syntax. If you understand the logic, you can also write this bubble sort into the Java, PHP, whatever the programming language you are comfortable, you can write on that programming language bubble sort. Okay, so let me explain in the simplest manner what is the bubble sort. Let me give you one example that what will happen when we will put one stone into the water. Yeah, suppose we have one bucket of water. If we will put one stone on that water bucket, what will happen? A stone will goes down into the ground of that bucket. Why? Because the weight of that stone is less as compared to water. We know the stone is heaviest as compared to water, so it will goes down. Let's take another example. What will happen when we will drop the two stone from the five floor? If the weight of one stone is 10 kg or suppose 1 kg and the another stone weight is 100 grams, which stone will touch first to the ground? Obviously, 1 kg stone will touch first to the ground. Why? Because the weight of that stone is heaviest as compared to the another stone. So like that, in this algorithm, we will do the swapping of each adjacent element, and the heaviest element will goes down first. Means like suppose here the 9 is the heaviest element, so it will goes first to the end of this array. Then in the second iteration, 8 will goes to in this place. So how actually it works, let me explain you. So suppose I have written this for loop here, you can see this. Okay, so in first iteration, what will happen? We will check these two elements. Okay, like here you can also see I have taken j is equal to 0 and n minus 1. So suppose this is my array. Okay, array. So how many elements? What is the length of this array? The length of this array is equal to 8. Okay, and index start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And 7. Okay, so 0 to 7, total element is 8. The length of the array is 8. Okay, so if we will run n, suppose n is the length, so n representing n equal to suppose 8. So how many times this for loop will run? N minus 1 means 7. So I should be less than 7. Okay, in each case. Okay, so it will run till here. Means less than 7 means 6. Okay, because if I will become 7, then this for loop, this condition will be false, because here I have taken j, so j should be less than 7. Okay, so till j 6, it will be satisfy the condition, so it will true. If j will become 7, then this for loop will be stopped. Okay, so let me explain from starting. So j is 0 initially, j is 0, and so here I'm checking the condition in if block. What I'm checking, if j is greater than j plus 1, means j plus 1 means 0 plus 1, this element. If j is greater than j plus 1, then swap these two value. And we know how we can swap these two value. We using third variable, we can swap also, and I'm not going on that thing. Okay, so you know we have to swap these two things. Okay, so we can swap using third variable, like temporary variable we can do. So what will happen? 3 will come here and 5 will goes there. So what will happen? In place of 5, 3 will come here and 5 will goes here. Again in the next step, j will become 1. So we will check 1 with 2. So again 5 will be checked with 1. So which one is heaviest? So 5 will come here and 1 will come here. Again, we will check with 5 with 9. 5 is greater than 9? No. So it will not affect. Then our pointer will come here and we'll check this. Okay, we'll check to this. Then what will happen? 8 will come here and 9 will go here. Again, we'll check these two. 4 and 5, we will check the index 4 and 5. So what will happen? 9 will came here. Again, we'll check. So here 4 will come and 9 will here. Again, we'll check 9 with 7. So 7 will come here and 9 will go there. So you can see in first iteration, 9 will come here. Okay. So after running one time, this entire for loop, heaviest element, which one is the heaviest? 9. So 9 has gone to the end of this array. Okay. So what will happen if we will run this loop again and again, and we will keep on trying to put the heaviest element to the end? In the second step, we will put the 8 to here. In the next iteration, we'll do the same thing. So let me go to the next step. What will happen after the first iteration? You can see 9 came here. Okay. So as I have already discussed in the first slide, that here you can see one for loop. If you will run one time this for loop, entire for loop, here you can see. Okay, so entire for loop. So what is happening? Only one element going to the end of the array. Okay, so if we will run the same for loop n minus one time, automatically, why? But here you can see one changes. Here I have written n minus 1, but here I have written n minus I minus 1. Can you understand why I have written this one? Because after once we have already placed 9 here, this is unnecessary checking again 9 in the condition. So why we will check if we have already means place the heaviest element to the end of that array? So it will run, means it's unnecessary of running the loop. So if you will remove this, still it will work perfectly. Okay, no problem will arise, but it will increase the running time of this algorithm. So we can do n minus 1 minus minus 1. So initially what will happen? N minus 1 I will be 0, so it will run n minus 1 time, means till the this element. Okay, it will run here. So again, index start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So you can see in this manner, we can run this for loop. If n time, then it will automatically swap. So after running the first iteration, 9 came here. After running the second iteration, we will leave this element. We will not check these two. And we will only run our loop till here. After the again next iteration, we will make the our loop one less. So we'll run our loop one less time, because it is unnecessary part. If we have already placed the last three heaviest element to the end, then why will check that element? We know. Okay, so in this way we can perform bubble sort. Hope you have understand. Let me show you the practical example of this algorithm. Okay, so let me explain the bubble sort in programming language. So here I have used the C++ syntax, as I have already told. Okay, so here you can see I have declared one array with 8 elements. Okay, you can see these are the 8 elements of array. Okay, so n will give us the length of array. N will become 8 because we have 8 elements, so n will store 8. How it's storing 8? Suppose we have 8 elements, size of each integer is 4 bytes. So 8 into 4, it will become 32. Okay. So what will be the size of first integer? 4. So 32 divided by 4, it will give 8. Okay. So n is 8. This is not required, because if you want to check the value of n, then you can write this one. Okay. So here you can see I have taken the two for loops. One is n minus 1, second will run. So this for loop is running independently. This for loop is not dependent in this for loop. If we will run this for loop once, it will only put the heaviest element to the end. Only one of heaviest element to the end. Suppose 9 in first iteration, it will come here, but if we will run n minus 1 time this for loop, then every element will automatically sorted, will come. Okay, if you have doubt, let me show you the practical example of this. Okay, so here you can see I have already written this program. If I will compile this program and if I will run, you can see 8. What is this 8? 8 is showing the size, because I have written here this. If I will close this and again I am saving this program and let me compile this program again, now I am running this program. Now you can see our array is sorted order. For printing I have taken this one. Okay, so hope you have understand the concept behind the bubble sort. If you like this video, please like this video. If you don't like, you can dislike this video. And if you are the new, then please subscribe my channel. And thank you guys for watching this video.